My name is William McNary, and I'm the president of U.S. Action. I want to first of all give you greetings from my Ohio affiliate, Progress Ohio. But at U.S. Action, we say there are three kinds of people. There are people that make things happen, there are people that watch things happen, and then there are people that don't know what's happening. I can't think of any place else in the world I would rather be on a Tuesday night than right here. Or postulate or pontificate about life, but people who are active participants in the movement for social justice and social change. I truly believe, because you all are gathered here this evening, that people are going to live longer. People will have more healthcare choices. Healthcare will be more affordable. People will all enjoy a higher quality of life because of the work that the citizens of Columbus have done, are doing, and most importantly, what y'all are getting ready to do. And because we activists are often inundated and undercompensated and underappreciated and seldom celebrated, why don't y'all celebrate yourselves right now? Challenging our heads with good information, challenging our hearts with good inspiration, and challenging our feet with good instruction. Having these feet at a rally like this is never a 50-50 proposition, I guarantee you. I've already received more wisdom and inspiration than I can give. So with that disclaimer, let me tell you like Elizabeth Taylor told her last husband, I won't keep you long. Because today is your day. This is your moment. This is your moment to go to your congresspeople and your senators and speak out on behalf of the majority of Americans, the 3 out of 4 that want you to succeed. Today is your day for a breakthrough. So just like these people behind me, remind them that healthcare reform is not just underwriting statistics or numbers on an actuarial table or issues on a profit statement or just another claim to review, adjust, and deny. These are real people. So go to your congresspeople and your senators and speak on behalf of the millions of uninsured, the underinsured, and the anxiously insured. Speak on behalf of those who are 1 union negotiation away from higher deductibles and co-pays. Speak on behalf of those who are 1 pink slip away from losing their coverage. Speak on behalf of those who are 1 major illness away from bankruptcy. And speak on behalf of the insured who are paying more and more and getting less and less. And you tell them we need quality healthcare that is affordable and offered to all, and you tell them we need a choice of a public health insurance plan. Because our opposition is united, and they're fighting together to uphold real healthcare reform because they're doing very well, thank you. They're profiting very nicely under the current arrangement that puts profits before people. How many of you have heard of a guy named H. Edward Hanway? Raise your hand. Let me tell you who H. Edward Hanway is. He is the CEO of the giant Cigna Insurance Company. He made $12.2 million last year. That's $5,883 an hour. He made 30 times more than the CEO of the United States, President Barack Obama. He made more money in a day than the average working stiff makes all year long. And then when he retires, guess what? He's going to get a golden parachute worth another $73 million. And that's why the private insurance companies are fighting us so hard. Not because it will drive them out of business, but it will have to change the way that they do. Denying coverage if you have pre-existing conditions, raising your premiums if you get sick, Fasting. Fasting. All those congresspersons and senators who say this is something we can't do, this is a nice idea, but we can't afford it, or whatever the excuse. That's a lot easier for them to say. We pay them in Congress $174,000 a year. We pay for them to have full medical coverage. We pay for full dental coverage. We pay for full vision coverage. We pay for whole life coverage for Congress. We pay for long-term care, the ones who stay there long enough as a part of their congressional purse. So if it's good enough for them, it's good enough for us. We're going to guarantee all kind of privilege for them. So stop being an incrementalist. Stop being an incrementalist. Give us the joy of the public health insurance plan that's affordable, comprehensive, equitable, and cover us all now. My brothers and sisters, this should not be about scoring political points. This is bigger than partisan politics. This is not just about Washington lobbyists and insiders. This is about you. This is about us. This is the fight that is going to determine who we are as a nation. And whether we reduce this battle to I got mine, you get yours, or whether we reaffirm the basic American idea that yes, we are responsible for ourselves, but we're also responsible for each other. I am my brother's people. I am my sister's people. This is our moment. We get ready to make history. It's surrounded by controversy, and truth is often the first casualty in a battle like this. You know, our opponents called Social Security a big government takeover when it was proposed in 1937. They called Medicare socialized medicine when it was proposed in 1964. And when Martin Luther King led the fight for freedom and equal rights, some people opposed him because they thought he was too radical. Others thought he was moving too fast. And I wasn't there when the freedom marches crossed the Edmund Pettus Bridge in Selma, Alabama, which led to civil rights and voting rights. But ask anybody who was there. Ask them who lived to talk about it. Their eyes will well up, and they'll speak of that moment with great pride. Well, I submit to you, my brothers and sisters, that this is one of those moments in history when our future generation, our children, and our children's children will be asking us, where were we in the fight for equality, healthcare reform, and we're going to have the courage that we're going to justify for our history and for our sake. So this is your moment. We can do this. We can make it. But in order to win, it takes three ingredients. Three ingredients. Number one, we got to be united. Number two, we got to be passionate. A little bit less Descartes, I think, therefore,